Allahu Akbar.
Looks like we're in time for Friday prayer.
My name is Ossama Bahloul. I'm the Imam of the Islamic Center here.
And were you here during the construction phase? What was your experience? I know around the country news came out that you faced a lot of conflict. How did you weather that?
We really, in so many ways, we have a very good experience.
Mm-hmm.
People could say, you know what, you had too much opposition and stuff, but it was an opportunity for us to learn a lot about America as a country and about the American people. And the beauty about being loyal to the Constitution, I learned that people can have their own perspective, but by the end of the day, if you do what's right in America, you will achieve what you want. Mm-hmm. And this is something that can become really obvious because we had a case in the court, and the one really fought in our behalf of is USA. I remember the U.S. attorney in the Middle District of Tennessee standing and saying USA against Rutherford County. And it was wonderful. So I really, although it was tough in some time because we had to work hard and we have to talk to so many people, but we met so many wonderful people, and I become more optimistic through this journey. And I would be very honest to say I really become more even proud of this country because of the justice process in America and the constitution of this country. And but what we have to do is we have to give each other a chance, and we have to get rid of any level of stereotype, and we have to talk to each other as people, and we must keep in mind that we are all related.
Mm-hmm.
So you might have a different color, different language, background, culture, or anything, but do you know what, by the end of the day, we all came from Adam and Eve. So if we can concentrate in this aspect, I think it might ease our way dealing with each other. People sometimes experience a heavy disagreement with us. What makes it easy for me reminding myself that he is my brother, she is my sister.
Mm-hmm.
And America is a wonderful country to be in after all. I came to learn how hard so many people work in America. We work closely with the officials, within the police department, with the sheriff department, with the FBI, with the Homeland Security, with the Department of Justice, and they work really, really hard. And sometimes it's not given for us to be safe. And they work countless hours. Those people work weekends, and they work day and night, and I really appreciate what they are doing. And I feel like what makes America so great is America being a place for everyone and welcoming everyone. And if America were to lose this, I think we would be all in trouble, because America is so special because of its stand for liberty and its belief in freedom, not only for its people, but for people everywhere. This is why we always express concern toward any war, and we love any peace activity. And we want to say, if there is a way for us to sit around the table, will be good. And resolving any conflict can be through talking. And you know what? I feel like I am right, but I might be wrong. And maybe he is wrong, but he might be right. If we were to adopt this way of communication, I think it would be better off. But I really appreciate the opportunity given to me to go through the experience of building this facility.
Mm-hmm.
I learned that the radical view is very much the view of extreme minority, and they might be vocal, but the majority of the people are very much reasonable. The majority of the people, meaning everyone, anyone you meet, he or she can be Muslim, Christian, or any other. The majority of the human beings are fine. And this is something we have to concentrate on. and we have to convey to others. We have to give our kids and the generation to come the opportunity to grow up being proud of themselves, because they have education and they have a lot to offer. And while we live in America, it's good for us to realize that we have a huge responsibility toward people in the middle, far east, the middle of Africa, and male and the female going through different level of struggle. They are waiting for our hand, and we must extend the hand to them. And talking to them, conveying what we have to them, is a way of helping instead of killing or instead of destroying people. Peace is not only good, peace is a necessity. Mm-hmm. We will not be able to survive as a human without us being able to talk to each other. We must keep in mind that we don't have to agree all of the time. You can have your way, and I will have my way. But by the end of the day, there is so much similarity between both of us. We want to have a good life. We want our kids to succeed. We want to have a safe country. We want everyone to be good. You want to drive a nice car if you are a young guy. She wants to have this bank car if she is a teenager female. And you know what? We all have this issue. Why don't we concentrate and we'll be able to achieve what we have in our mind, and it will be good. That's it. That's it. Good.
Yes. Thank you.